Hi friends, we are all very glad to meet you through this YouTube channel Soul to Win. This will be our last video on the Corona series. Today we are going to discuss about the amount of death it brought into the entire world. In 2018, the world population was 760 crore.
Every second there are 5 people who are born in this world, and every second there are 2 people who die in this world.
All have different problems in this world, but when we understand how little or how tiny we are in this big world, in this big universe, all these problems will become very little. We all die due to different reasons. There are 282 illnesses which is found by the IHME Institute. The Institute of Health and Metrics Evaluation states that in a week there are almost less than 20,000 people who die because of suicide, and almost 20,000 people who die because of diabetes, and almost 25,000 people who die because of road accidents, and 36,000 people who die because of lungs and trachea cancers, and there's almost 49,000 people who die because of pneumonia and bronchitis, and there are almost 60,000 people who die in a week due to pulmonary diseases. In this chart, the newly entered disease, that is Corona, has ranked number 2. But have we ever given this amount of serious thought for the other diseases is a question. Okay, let's park all these serious thoughts and get into some interesting facts which is around the word birth and death. When you enter into this world, that is your birth. The interesting fact around your birth is that you did not select your parents. You did not select the country you will be born in. You did not select the language you will speak. You did not select your physique. You did not select anything of those when you are born into this world. Our life in this world is uncertain. It is indefinite. But we all actively participate in this drama, not knowing when the curtains will fall down and when the show will end. In the entire human lifespan, almost 1/3 to 1/4 of their life is spent in sleep. And this sleep is a rehearsal for your final death. While you're sleeping, just imagine who was taking care of your problems. Understand this fact that nobody can be the reason for my death, and no disease can be the reason for my death. If we have this reason strongly stuck to our mind, then we'll be throwing away people from our boundaries. We'll be rejecting people from our life, saying, you have this disease, you don't have this talent, you don't have this knowledge with you. The moment you discriminate a person, you have already killed that person. Remember, rejection is equivalent to death. Well, then what is life? If I fulfill my own desires, is that life? Everybody's life has a purpose. Nobody's is greater than the other person. Nobody's dream is greater than the other person's dream. If I live a life to fulfill others' purpose and others' dream, that is the real life. Let me illustrate it to you through an example. Just imagine there's the last piece of food on a plate and there are 2 people. One, I can have the food or I can give it to another person. The moment I am not giving to another person, I'm actually denying their life. I'm actually killing that person already. But if I share that with the other person, that is where I let the other person live. Talking about food, I always wonder the way our stomach is designed. Maybe our wallet or our bank balances can hold a lot of property, but the stomach which is designed for us can hold only a meal or 2. Anything that is accumulated is a disease. If there is an increased sugar accumulation, then it leads to diabetes. If there is an increased salt, then it leads to blood pressure. And if there is a water stagnated somewhere, it starts to stink there. Likewise, in a healthy society to be formed, the love should flow frequently. The love should flow without any disturbance. The money should flow without any disturbance. Death is inevitable. But the moment you desire to live for others' wishes and dreams, that's where you destroy the meaning of death. And that's where the real life comes into picture. Before we wind up, there are 2 dreams which I want to pose. The first one, the world without robbery. There's something which we have stolen from the other person that he wants to take it from us. Can we acknowledge that and give it before that? Second one is a world of equality. A person who's working in the restroom has been working for 10 years or 20 years, but he is not paid as much as a person who's working inside an air-conditioned room. Thank you for listening to us. Keep watching this space for more interesting thoughts.